is depressing to see. Cause you know you can't be better than me. Start at the bottom and long for the top. I'll always be here to make your dreams stop. I've got it all from head to toe. Looks, brains, class, you'll never know. Second place is the best you'll ever do. Be happy with that before I do worse to you. My goal. My life's on fire and you're ice cold. What could you do that would ever scare me? All of you out there, I'm a dog, you're a flea. Anything you can do, I can do better. Even when I rap more better. It's like this body when wrapped in leather. Perfection, and it gets no better. I rap like I wrestle, envy of others. The only white rapper in tune with the brothers. Hello, all eyes on me, and if I was you, best believe I'd keep my eyes on me. 200 plus pounds of a body splendid. Braggadocious, oh so ferocious. Focused, history suspended. Skills uncontended. Live at the top. Attributes won't stop, stop. Master the ring and the mic alike. Eloquent with words while I move cat-like. Hot, oh, I can't be stopped. And now rap meets rock. And it's time that you drop, drop.
From WWE Originals, that was Kurt Angle himself singing the I Don't Suck, Really. So, yeah, take it or leave it, I guess. This is Fatboy Mark Jabroni. You are listening to Ring Rust on 93.4 CHMR FM. So, next up from lockdown this past Sunday night, it wasn't a terribly good show, was it? I mean, it's shows like that that show you just how logical some might say that I don't want to pay for their pay-per-views, you know. But also, though, it sort of suggests like, well, why are you still watching them then? I mean, if you're watching the pay-per-views just to complain about them, then you're doing it wrong. As far as I'm concerned, I mean, I watch it because I want to watch it. I don't watch it because I want to make fun of it. I watch it because I want to see it. I want to see the show. I enjoy watching wrestling. Whether or not you personally agree that Impact Wrestling is wrestling is beside the point, really. You can have whatever opinion you want about what you like and what you don't like. I enjoy watching WWE and TNA wrestling. If you don't, then find something else to watch on Monday, Thursday, and Friday nights when those shows come on. I mean, it's simple logic. It goes against human nature to continue exposing yourself to something that you don't enjoy. You know, it's like going to visit your in-laws or going to church on Christmas, right? If you're not an overly religious person. You go to church on Christmas because you feel some sort of duty to do it. Nobody has a duty to watch TNA wrestling. No one has a duty to watch pay-per-views. If you don't want to watch them, then don't watch them. If you don't want to watch Raw, don't watch Raw. If you don't want to watch Impact, don't watch Impact. If you don't want to watch SmackDown, don't watch SmackDown. It's simple logic. I often use the analogy of, you know, on The Cosby Show, way back when they introduced the character of Olivia. If when the character of Olivia was introduced and you said, oh, I absolutely hate that character, I can't stand watching her on TV. If you continued to watch The Cosby Show, regardless of the fact that she was on the show, then you're either a masochist or a hypocrite for saying that you hate this character, but you won't stop watching the show. Not Kent, because all you have to do is not turn it on the next time it comes on. It's not like someone's sitting you down saying, you watch this show, or I'm going to, I don't know, hurt you. I'm going to tie your girlfriend to this train track and wait for the train to come by. I don't know. I'll throw your dog out into traffic, or I'll, you know, push your grandmother down these stairs. If you don't sit down and watch this show, I'm going to do something horrible to you if you don't sit down and watch the show. Nobody's doing that. Nobody's forcing you to watch Raw or Impact or SmackDown. If you don't like the shows, if you don't like the fact that John Cena is in the position he's in, stop watching. If you're in the United States, WWE is actually paying attention to what you say, usually, in some way. If you have a Nielsen box, doubly so. If you have some way to submit your ratings, you know, your viewership to them, they're sitting with bated breath waiting to hear what you have to say. If you stop watching Raw and stop watching SmackDown and stop watching Impact Wrestling, somebody eventually is going to say, you know, less people are watching shows. And they'll, you know, sit down and they'll say, okay, do we need to change something? Do we need to do something? And please, guys, stop saying you need to turn John Cena heel. Okay? Stop saying that. It's boring. It was boring to me when people started saying it. It's super boring to me now. Because right now, people are booing for John Cena. People are booing for the fact that he's not a heel yet. So, in essence, he's already a heel. Because you're booing. You dislike what he's doing. You have no positive reaction to what he's doing. You have a negative reaction to what he's doing. So, from that vantage point, he's the 21st century heel. He's doing what he has to do to make you not like him. And what he has to do, apparently, is exactly what he's doing. He's being himself, as far as I'm concerned. He's doing what he's been doing. So, it's just my opinion, though. And this microphone in front of me means that I have a chance, the opportunity, the privilege to broadcast this opinion to you, the Siege of Mara listener, and to my podcast listeners after the fact. Via my YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/fanboymarkjabroni, or via the sunsetflipshow.com website, where the show's been archived for the past 2 or 3 months, I think, in varying forms. I try to keep it, like, no more than two parts. I have to edit a little bit specially for that, just to put it in 2 one-hour blocks and then edit the two one-hour blocks into something I can put on YouTube. Anyway, so that little rant out of the way, let's head back to the lockdown pay-per-view results from this past Sunday. The next match they have is Kurt Angle versus Jeff Hardy. And Kurt Angle being Kurt Angle, being the bad guy in this match, he's doing everything he can to get a cheap win out of it, but Jeff Hardy's not going to have any part of it. Jeff Hardy climbs the top turnbuckle. Actually, does he? No, he climbs to the top of the cage. He does what I guess would be considered a super swanton from the top of the cage for the pin. And again, I'm not going to play Jeff Hardy's TNA theme because I think I played his two TNA themes in the past 2 weeks. So let's try something from WWE, shall we? Loaded. 93.5 Siege from FM. Hindsight, rather ironic name.
listening to Wrestling Superstar, the Triple X Sex Express, Sexy Eddie, and you're listening to Ring Rust, the one and only wrestling talk radio show.
It's showtime. 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 Showtime.
This is Salvador Fernandez. I invite you to listen to Ritmo Latino, a weekly one-hour show of pure salsa, merengue, reggaeton, bachata, cumbia, and underground tropical rhythms every Saturday afternoon at 3 p.m. on CHMR 93.5 FM and on the web on CHMR.ca.
Musicalizando, DJ Chumba.
Join me on Fridays from 7 to 9 p.m. for Back to the Past. I'll have all the best music from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s.
Tune in every Friday afternoon to CHMR for the Heterosexual Cavalcade of Uber Swank for an hour of the best in Canadian music. That's 3 p.m. Newfoundland time. Or if you're listening on the internet at www.chmr.ca, it's 1:30 p.m. Eastern Standard.
Everyone's watching to see what you will do. Everyone's looking at you. Oh.
I just want to tell you both, good luck. We're all counting on you.